Now, TJ Smith.
Knowledge, experience, and passion.
WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
Welcome back to the show. We are having a conversation about the commissioner, Michael Harrison, who has exited. He's exited stage left. He's going on to take a rest first. And I'm assuming he's going to resurface. We had him on the show just this past Monday, and I asked him the questions of what he might be doing in his future. And he said, he still had some juice left in his tank, but one of the places he wouldn't be going was Washington, D.C. Matter of fact, here's exactly what he said.
Well, I think I'm still young. I'm just made 54. I love what I do. I've been doing this for 32 years. I've been a chief now for nine consecutive years. I still have the juice, and I love this job. I love this profession, and I made a commitment. But let me look you in the eye. Let me metaphorically look your listeners in the eye. I am not going to Washington, D.C.
So he's not going to the Washington Metropolitan Police Department, but might he surface somewhere else? Yeah, he has the right to do that, so we shall see. And many people in Baltimore, from some of the text messages, won't care where he ends up. The reactions are still coming in as to his moving on, and we've gotten a statement in from State Senator Corey McCray. He says, in part, Commissioner Michael Harrison worked to achieve admirable results in reducing violent crime, utilizing data to hone in on our community most impacted while being focused on implementing our federally mandated consent decree with the United States Department of Justice. I wish him well in his next chapter, one that I know that serving Baltimore has helped him prepare for. There is no doubt that in this moment, our city needs a police commissioner who is a skilled crime fighter who works hand in hand with law enforcement partners while also working to increase the public trust. I look forward to supporting Interim Police Commissioner Rich Worley. I've worked closely with Interim Commissioner Worley and have found him to be an experienced law enforcement professional. I am confident that he knows the direction that Baltimore's crime-fighting strategy must go in. And again, that's Maryland State Senator Corey McCray, who issued a statement in reference to Michael Harrison, commissioner and now former commissioner, who's leaving. In just a few moments, we'll also hear from Councilman Eric Costello, who, I'm going to tell you, he started this. I started it, asking the question. But following up that evening, he was on with the budget hearings. He asked the pointed questions of the commissioner that night. And we saw what his reaction was that evening when he took a recess and had to walk out. So we'll find out a little bit more about that when we talk to him in just moments here on the T.J. Smith Show here on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5. The number here is 410-467-WBAL and also 410-467-9225 on the greensolutionsremodeling.com text line. Let's hear from Donald in Baltimore. Donald, good morning. You're on WBAL.
Good morning, and God bless you, CJ.
Thank you.
To Donald Harrison, good riddance.
Okay.
I have an idea for a challenger for Brandon Scott.
Okay.
Jay Miller.
Okay.
He has a brain and a heart, and she loves Baltimore.
All right. Well, Donald, thank you very much. I'm going to pass that on to Jane, who does the Saturday morning shows from 11 to 1 here, and that would produce an opening if she decided she wanted to jump on and become a candidate for mayor of Baltimore. Again, there haven't been any candidates yet that I've seen that have absolutely gotten in. There are people exploring. I know that. Texter texts in and says, in my opinion, absolutely ridiculous that our mayor was elected with 27% of the vote. It was 29% to be exact. It was 29.6%, so we round up 30%. We need runoffs, and you must receive at least 50% of the vote to be elected like the rest of the world. Again, that's the primary election, and one of the things that I've been an advocate for that I've talked about often is ranked choice voting. I'll let you explore that more. We'll talk about it more in another show, but that would make it possible for somebody to get to 50% before we had a declared winner, and that would get more buy-in, in my opinion. Let me go back to the phone lines and get Will Hanna over in Park Heights. Will, good morning. You're on WBAL. Will, you there? Yep, there you go.
I'm here. Can you hear me?
I got you. Yep.
Okay. So what I think we have to understand is that now our public safety is in disarray.
Mm.
You had the director, Monzi, who stepped down a couple weeks ago. Now you have the police commissioner leaving. And the question has to be, is there something more behind why they're leaving at the time that they're leaving? Is it that they are frustrated with the mission and feel like they can't get it accomplished? Because not a lot has changed in either of their tenures.
Right.
So I think that those are a couple things that we have to look at.
Mm-hmm.
And right now, I would dare say that there was one name that people had talked about for the last five or probably 7-8 years as someone that could be a great choice and probably be the first woman police commissioner in Baltimore City's history, would be Sabrina Tapp Harper. I would just want to make sure that a lot of people know her, a lot of people know her work.
Okay, yep. Thank you very much, Will. Always appreciate you calling. And Sabrina Tapp Harper last worked for the sheriff's office. She was, I believe, deputy sheriff or undersheriff. She was up there, maybe a captain or major in the sheriff's office, and a retired Baltimore police higher up. But it looks like the mayor has made his decision. He's not doing the national search. He's not even going to put up a front as a national search. His decision is Rich Worley. That's who he's choosing. That's who he's going to nominate. And that's who he's going to put in front of the council. And we'll see how the council hearings go and what route they go, if this is going to be a relatively easy process to get him confirmed as the next commissioner for Baltimore City. Let's go to CJ in Baltimore. CJ, good morning. You're on WBAL.
Yeah, have a good one. All right.
Hey, CJ, you're on the radio. I had to come back to you, CJ. All right, we'll get back to CJ because he's having side conversations. But somebody texted in and said, Brandon Scott's micromanagement style has led to an unprecedented exodus from top-level positions and still his first term. He's seemingly willingness to listen to colleagues or citizens of Baltimore is what is going to cost him re-election or not listening. And to the texter, that has kind of been a bit of a common theme that I've heard, or I've heard that theme before. And one of the things that I've been critical about is maybe the lack of management. You know, that in and of itself could present a problem. And when you are put in a position to manage people and manage people at such a high level, that can cause significant problems, right? And seeing the exodus, that is of real concern. And as the another texter just texted in, common denominator, Brandon Scott, yes, that's a fact. We have to keep that, you know, it's not a you problem, it's a me problem. And that's something we have to, keep in perspective. Again, I look at it as a wonderful problem that the commissioner was there for the transition this morning. That's a big thing. And I'm telling you, y'all been around here long enough, you know how these normally happen. It's normally the new smiling face commissioner there with the smiling face mayor, and they done threw somebody else under the bus. We know how it normally happens, right?